This in my hand is a backlit paper. This was made on the 360. Ordinarily, you would make backlits like this on a translucent, with a transmissive, it is a semi-translucent paper, you would use a transmissive spectrophotometer. Probably the best known one is a Barbieri. The thing is, Barbieris tend to be a little pricey. And if you want to do something that is on a clear, or on some papers, or possibly a translucent backlit banner, and you don't have one of these Barbieris, and you want to be aware that this isn't the perfect way to do this, but there is sort of a secret workflow on the printer through the adhesive vinyl selection that will allow you to have access to higher ink loads, and those higher ink loads will allow you to more or less build a pretty decent equivalent of a backlit without having the Barbieri. Now, our first recommendation, of course, is to go on the media locator and see if your media you've chosen is on the locator, or start with a locator and then buy that media. You can also use the media locator to use a surrogate. So, for example, if you had Ultraflex View Light, which is a backlit banner, you might be able to use the 3M Panagraphics preset because they're both backlit banners. It would translate reasonably well. You find things on the locator that are like what you have and then use those instead. That turns out very well most of the time. But let's say you wanted to build your own. This is an on-demand backlit paper. It has sort of a heavy vellum coating to it. We've also seen some Nina papers that are very similar. And what I'm doing is I'm putting a heavy ink load on the paper. This is a good short-term outdoor backlit, you know, like a bus stop or something. Inexpensive, effective. You just need to get some more ink down on it. As you can see, it's over-inked, but it looks really nice when you put it in a light box or in a window. So what I have here is a print chart. Now, this is just like our traditional speed chart or a temperature speed ink load chart, except the difference is when you load and tell the media it's adhesive vinyl, like creating a new media, instead of telling it that it's a frontlit, tell it it's a backlit. You're going to get this chart. So this was printed at 12 pass, and it gives you an option from 130% to 200%. What this is giving me is a much wider range of ink. It's putting more ink down. Obviously, 200% ink is twice what 100 is. So at 12 pass, I'm printing this chart. It looks pretty good. What I'm going to do is, if this is a translucent or a paper that has backlit capability, I can use that workflow, create the preset right, and do the color work right on the printer. Now, it's going to read it refractively. That's not ideal, but it's not bad either. I found that using this workflow for things like translucents, some clears, some backlit papers, as long as it can take the ink, it's not a half bad way to build a preset in a pinch when I don't have any alternatives. I've used it for some backlit banners, for example. I've used it for some clears. And the end result has been pretty satisfactory. Here's some other things you could use it for. Maybe some window perf. See, with window perf, when you print on it and you peel it away, all those holes, they reduce the effectiveness of the amount of ink. So I tend to treat window perf like I want to put more ink on it because I know that when I pull those holes away, it's going to lighten it up considerably. So window perf, you might use a higher ink load, let's say 150, 170, even as high as 200, but you're going to have to go a little slower. You could also use it for some canvases. There are some canvases, for example, that will allow you to take, say, 150% ink, and it will make it a little richer. Now, you may have to go to 16 pass or 12 pass to do it, but you can put the extra ink on. I've used it for translucents. So, you know, peel away backlit vinyl that goes on a plexi face. I've used it even for some coated fabrics. I've taken a coated fabric, like Ultraflex makes a nice coated fabric, put it on the printer, print directly on the platen, and tell it it's an adhesive vinyl. Now, I know that sounds kind of nutty, it's clearly a fabric, but I change the settings. So in the advanced tab, I'll change the settings so that they match fabric settings. The adhesive vinyl backlit preset choice kind of thinks it's a vinyl, but if you change the settings, it functions just like a fabric, and you run it through and do the profile, color calibration, and presets, ICC, right on the printer. In this case, I'm starting out, I think I chose 170%, and I'm then going to go to the panel, which is over here, and normally if you did a high ink load in another category than adhesive vinyl, it's going to say NA, not applicable, not going to let you do it. But when you choose adhesive vinyl, it says recommended. So I named it, and you hit recommended, and print the next chart, and that's going to do its calibration. Then I'm going to do an ICC, or in some cases on a 310 or 330, I'm going to do a partial or kind of a generic plus or a partial profile where I'm just going to hit finish, and then the printer is going to choose a category profile automatically for me. Sometimes that's actually a better choice. But at the minimum, I'm going to be able to get at a higher ink load, and it's going to let me make a custom preset with calibration for a material that I'm going to put more ink down than usual. Now, I do have some customers using this workflow to try to put more ink on a front-lit adhesive vinyl. That's fine. You could even go up to maybe 150%. I've even seen a little higher. Be aware, though, that you're not necessarily getting any more color gamut. Just because you're putting more ink down, sometimes there's sort of a limit, and you're not going to get any more color gamut on a front-lit print. Definitely go and check your ICC evaluation in your tools menu, say in Onyx, and see if you're really getting more gamut by bringing that out and the colors you're targeting or not. In some cases, I think you'll find there's virtually no advancement. All you're doing is putting more ink down. Keep in mind, too, that when you're doing a heavy ink load, you may have to you almost certainly have to slow the printer down, because you have to make sure that amount of ink can be fully cured at whatever temperature you're putting down. And you're putting down quite a bit of extra ink. If you over-ink it and you don't fully cure it, it could affect lamination. The lamination you're using could become a little unstable, or it isn't as effective. You can have other image quality issues happening because you've got so much ink there and you don't have a complete or full cure. So when you get up to 150, 170, 200% ink, you probably have to go to 16 pass really to make that work. That's just the nature of putting a high ink load on a material, but it is doable. And in a lot of cases, I found that the onboard process here is pretty satisfactory. It's not as good as the Barbieri, but it's not $10,000 extra either, and it gets the job done in a pinch. It's sort of my secret workflow, but I thought I'd let you in on it. We did it to make this these papers here, put these up in the light box. They look really good, very nice, using a heavy ink load on the 360. Okay, secret workflow.